This might be useful in the future. I don't see any reason for it currently. But it does depend. Because if you can warp out, then it doesn't matter. And anyways, I'm getting ahead of myself. So, anyways, let's go ahead and kill Harry. We're gonna do it just like the movies did, except no Voldemort and no Abracadabra and no weird fucking dream or anything like that. Instead, we're gonna boost up into the air and then warp out with Quidditch and then heal ourselves. I have a lot of potions, and so it does require at least one, maybe two, I think. But the major point is that you want to be using your Q. So let me go ahead and do this. So, and it takes two Quidditch matches too, I believe. So let me go ahead and die. No, that's not far enough. Okay, and then we're gonna. Doesn't matter what we do this part. Harry's dead, right? Oh, he actually might have. No, well, let's see. So, Harry's in the death loop, right? And he'll just keep dying over and over and over and over and over again. But instead of that, what you can do is as soon as the screen stops loading, and you have your, you can mash it, I guess. But just mash Q until you get the green thing. Might have waited too long. Yeah, I waited too long. Hold on. Let me go. I should be able to do it from here. Okay, mashing Q. Hear the thing, you see the green, right? Okay, so then what's great about Quidditch is it takes whatever health you had prior and stores it somewhere, because it replaces your health with Quidditch health. I don't know what else to call it, but that's what it basically is. So if you put, like, okay, so if I were to get that green bar of health like I just had normally, and then die, it would just load the save where I had no health. But because Quidditch takes the previous health that you had, which was a full bar of green, it allows you to be alive afterwards. Now, I accidentally found this because of a gnome. I was trying to figure out why I didn't have my wand anymore. So I was seeing if I could do it anywhere else besides the gnome. It turns out it's only on the gnome that it works. Because if you jump on top of a gnome and then get clipped into a wall while on the gnome, it doesn't kill you, like it doesn't void out, so you're just dead. You can't do anything while on top of a gnome, you're just laying down. But I warped out from there with the Quidditch warp and did this combination of things, and then I was like, oh cool, I could run around. And then I realized I could have cast, because Harry just didn't have his wand at all. So I guess the gnome had my wand still, and you can't go back in or anything, so that's fine. But yeah, that's basically it. A way to cheat death, technically, as long as you have at least one potion. I don't know if it'll be useful anywhere, but it is something. regardless, and it also makes it so we don't have to have if we can die into a door, we don't have to have a cutscene on the other side, but technically speaking, it still wouldn't change anything for that, because for instance, a boom sling, well, boom sling has a cutscene. Anywhere where it doesn't have a cutscene, you just load in, you would normally just die, but if you warp out, you probably can't get in anyways, cause unless the game state changes, so then warping out would have been the more beneficial thing, I guess. Well, actually, no, you could die into the door and then warp out. Oh, well, I don't know. I'm rambling. Good luck. Have fun. That's it.